Hello friends, I'm Naval Yemul, working as an assistant professor in Mechanical Engineering Department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this video, we are going to see Scilab mattresses. Learning outcome. At the end of this session, students will be able to perform basic matrix operations on Scilab. Content of the video is introduction, arithmetic operations for matrices, basic matrix operations. Introduction. A matrix in layman's language is tabular data arranged in rows and columns. Let us see an example of a matrix. A matrix A with 3 rows and 3 columns. This can be defined in Scilab in a single line with rows separated by the semicolon. In the previous video, I have shown you how the Scilab vector or row vector and the column vector is defined in Scilab. So here, if you want to define a matrix, we need to define in a single line with the rows separated by a semicolon. So when you enter this in Scilab, you get output like this. So we'll have a quick, we'll take an input A is equal to a square bracket 11 comma 12, comma indicates it is in row, semicolon indicates it will shift in the second column, 21 space, you can give comma also, 22 comma 23, then semicolon, then 31 comma 32 comma 33, bracket complete, enter. So this is a matrix A with three rows and three columns. So any element of the matrix can be referred to by specifying its row and column indices. If you want to access the second element of the first row, we may refer to it as A1, 2. That one refers row and this two refers column. For example, these are the columns and these are the rows. So here 1, 2 refers first row and second column here. So if you want to specify or if you want to access to this second element, so the function will be A1, 2. So when you press A1, 2 in a curly bracket, you get output as 12. We'll just check in Scilab here. So A, capital A, because we have defined as capital A, 1, 2. When you press enter, so it will be access, that is 12. The element 1, 2 position is shown here. So next, in the same way, if you want to show the position of 2, 3, it will be 23. You can just check here, A 2, 3. So here, that is second row, third column, the element is 23. When you press enter, you get the second row, third element. Next, to overwrite any defined value, we can simply reassign it by using A2, 3 is equal to 0. You can assign any value to any element or any position. So it is very simple. The output will be like this. So the second row, third column is overwritten by 0. You can try this with different numbers also. So A2, 3 should be assigned or should be equal to, suppose, 05. Just press enter. So this second row third element, so this position is replaced by number 5. You can try with different numbers. So A, capital A, 2, 3 is equal to 0. When you press enter, so 2, 3 is replaced as 0. You can try with different positions also. for example, A, 1, 2 should be replaced with 3. Just press enter. So this 1, 2, that is first row and second column, is replaced by number 3. You can replace any number with any position. The command will be, we call matrix A in a round bracket. First we'll call row, then column. So the next, arithmetic operators for matrix. So basic arithmetic, addition, subtraction and multiplication are done on matrices in Scilab in exactly the same way as they are traditionally defined in mathematics. These operations work only if the size of the matrix are compatible. That is, the size of the matrix should be same, then only this basic arithmetics are performed. In case of addition and subtraction, the matrices have to be exactly the same dimension. And in the case of multiplication also, the matrix should be of same dimensions. Here I have defined two matrices A and B. A and B, I have done the addition of these two matrices. That is, I have taken in the third variable C, A plus B, matrix A added with matrix B, the output would be this one, 3, 5, 7, 9. This is basic what we do in a matrix addition. I'll just clear this all. The command for clearing the console window is CLC. Suppose I have taken A, matrix is equal to 1 space 2 comma semicolon 3 space or comma 4, enter B, then I am taking semicolon 4 comma 5. Just press enter. The B is defined. So there are two matrix A and B. Suppose if you want to add these two matrix in a new variable called C, you can write C is equal to A plus B and just type enter. You get the addition of these two matrices. In the same way, you can take A minus B, and the subtraction operator we use is minus. Just press enter, you get subtraction of matrix A and B. So it is very simple. So B minus A or A minus B, you can perform any operation. And multiplication is also very easy. A, we use asterisk sign or asterisk symbol, into B, you get multiplication of the two vectors. So pause the video for few seconds and think what all matrix operations you can perform on Scilab apart from this addition, subtraction, multiplication, what you can perform. Pause the video for few seconds and think on this. Okay, so we'll discuss this question later on in the video. So basic matrix operations. In this section, we shall see how to handle a matrix, including a navigation through it in special ways and implementing common operations such as transpose, inverse, etc. One of these basic information about the matrix is its dimension. For two-dimensional matrix, it is of the form m, n, where m is number of rows and n is number of columns, as I have discussed in the previous video. We can use size function. So here size function is used in Scilab to determine the dimensions of a matrix as demonstrated below. Suppose I have taken a matrix, that is A matrix of 3 rows and 3 columns, and when I use a function size of A, the command or the function is size of A, the output would be 3 and 3, that it shows 3 rows and 3 columns. So we'll perform this operation in Scilab. So first I'll clear the console window, then I'll take a new matrix. I'll just press enter. So when I type size of A and just press enter, it shows 3 and 3, that is 3 rows and 3 columns. So in the same way, the function diagonal, to finding the diagonal elements, the function is DIAG and curly bracket or round brackets. So the function DIAG of matrix shows the diagonal elements. To find the sum of diagonal elements, the function is trace. So you need to remember trace is finding the sum of diagonal elements. So trace of matrix A gives the sum of all diagonal elements. The lower triangular matrix whose elements above diagonal elements are 0 is obtained by using tri L, that is lower triangular. So the function is tri L of A, it gives you the lower triangular matrix. In the same manner, you can go with upper triangular matrix. For upper triangular matrix, the function is tri U. And you can find the transpose of the matrix, and it is very simple, that is A dash gives you the transpose of the matrix. So here, if I want to find the diagonal DIAG diagonal of A, and if I enter, you get the diagonal elements here. And if you want to sum those diagonal elements, the command is trace of A, just press enter, you will get sum of all the diagonal elements. And if you want to find the upper triangular matrix or lower triangular matrix, the command or the function is tri L of matrix A. So here, above the diagonal elements, all the elements becomes 0. In the same way, I can use tri U of A, just press enter. So diagonal elements below it becomes 0, that is called upper triangular matrix. So you can find A inverse also, just write A dash and enter it. So your columns are converted into rows and your rows are converted into. So these are the references I have used. Thank you.